हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू इंडियन जुडिशियल सर्विस। टुडेज वी आर टेकिंग हियर क्वेश्चन नंबर 121 to 140। दिस इज द पार्ट 8 ऑफ टॉप 400 एमसीक्यू ऑफ कोड ऑफ क्रिमिनल प्रोसीजर। नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 121, द प्रीवियस स्टेटमेंट ऑफ विटनेस विच कैन बी यूज फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ कंट्राडिक्टिंग द विटनेस एज प्रोवाइडेड। हियर इंपॉर्टेंट वर्ड इज कंट्राडिक्टिंग द विटनेस एज प्रोवाइडेड अंडर द प्रोविजो 2 सबसेक्शन 1 ऑफ सेक्शन 162 सीआरपीसी मे बी द वन। ऑप्शन ए हियर रिड्यूस इन राइटिंग, ऑप्शन बी नॉट रिड्यूस इन राइटिंग, ऑप्शन सी ओरल, ऑप्शन डी आइदर ए और बी और सी। सो हियर आंसर इज ऑप्शन ए रिड्यूस इन राइटिंग। नंबर 122, वेयर द बिटनेस इज कॉल्ड बाय द कोर्ट एज कोर्ट बिटनेस। हियर the called by court as court witness the previous statement made by him to the police can. So their previous statement of witness under section 161 of CRPC. So option is here A, be used by accused for contradicting such witness, be used by the prosecution for contradicting such witness with the permission of court. Option C here, either A or B, not to be used either by the accused, here not to be used, and or by prosecution for any purpose. So in this question the witness is called by the court as a court witness. So here answer is option D, not to be used either by accused or by prosecution for any purpose. Now question number 123, in re-examination the previous statement made to a police officer can be used for option A, the purpose of contradicting what is the state in the cross-examination, option B here, the purpose of explaining what is left over the examination in chief, option C, the purpose of explaining any matter in the cross examination, option D, all of the above. So here option C is correct. Here the purpose of explaining any matter in cross examination. So there are three type of examination: examination in chief in according to the Evidence Act, examination chief, cross examination, re-examination. So here the question is re-examination, the previous statement made to a police officer can be used for in the purpose of explaining any matter in the cross examination. So option C is correct here. Now question number 124, which of the following is not outside the provision of section 162 subsection 1 of CRPC. Option A, the statement fall under section 32 subsection 1 of the Indian Evidence Act. So the option B, the statement falling under section 27 of the Indian Evidence Act. Option C, the statement recorded by police officer during investigation. And option D, either A nor B, sorry here, neither A nor B nor C. So here answer is option C, the statement recorded by police officer during investigation. So in this question the which of the following is not outside the provision of subsection 1 of section 162 of CRPC, the statement recorded by police officer during investigation. Now we are talking here concerned with the matter of section subsection 1 of section 32 and section 27. Section 30, subsection 1 of section 32 is related to when the witness giving the statement related to cause of death. This section is the exception of the law of direct evidence, because these persons are according to section 32, it provide the provision of the the evidentiary value of the witness, witness document, who is not appear, who is not calling before the court in proper time, and he is very costly, or a person who is not found or dead. So one of them is here the related to a cause of death. So here the statement of a person who is deceased, deceased person who is dead. So subsection 1 of section 32 is provided this thing here. And now section 27 provided, this section is not CRPC, it is Evidence Act. So how much information, very important section here, how much information received from accused, may be proved, here very important word, may be proved by police. Because according to section 25, the any evidence giving before the police is irrelevant. But in this section, the it provide that how much information is to be received from the accused may be proved. So this section is provided this thing here. Now question number 125. A non-compliance with the provision of section 164 of CRPC, the reduce the statement recorded by the magistrate to a nullity. It is an irregularity curable under section 463 of CRPC, both A and B, neither A nor B. So here option A is correct here, reduce the statement recorded by the magistrate to a nullity. So here non-compliance means here when the magistrate is taking the examination of accused and he take the he force the accused to take an oath, and when he giving the statement of related to the confession. So such type of is he reduced his statement in nullity. Now question number 126. The confession of an accused. Confession of accused, the statement of witness under section 164 CRPC can be recorded during inquiry, investigation, trial, either A, B, C. So it is clear here, option B is correct here. During investigation. So when the magistrate record a confession, such confession is signed but not oath. If such confession is on the oath, such confession becomes irrelevant, but it must be signed by the accused as well as magistrate who record the statement of the accused. On this provision related to the investigation, during the investigation. Now question number 127. The confession of accused on the statement of witness under section 164 of CRPC may be recorded before the beginning of investigation, in the course of investigation only, in the course of investigation, or at any time after, before the commencement of the inquiry or trial. Option D, in the course of investigation, or at any time afterward during the inquiry but before the commencement of trial. So here answer is option C, in the course of investigation, first important here point, and after or before the commencement of inquiry and trial. Afterward, before the commencement, when before the commencement of inquiry and trial. Now question number 128. The confession under section 164 CRPC can be recorded by Metropolitan Magistrate, Judicial Magistrate, Executive Magistrate, Police Officer on whom the power of magistrate has been conferred, either A or B. I already expressed these terms, this all the subject matters of related to this topic in previous video. And if you are not watching the previous video, please watch here. I provide the link in description box of previous video. Now answer is clear here. Option A, metropolitan magistrate and judicial magistrate can record the examination of witness or accused. So according to section 164. So option A is correct here. So here, not executive magistrate and police officer who has the power of magistrate is also not able to record the examination of witness or accused. Now question number 129, the maintenance of case diary, here case diary by an investigating officer is a directory, mandatory, discretionary, neither B nor C. So it is option B, mandatory. It is mandatory provision. According to section 172 provided that the police officer, investigating officer, here IO, investigation officer, cell, very important word, this is cell, mandatory provision, recording day to day entry, so day to day entry, day to day enter his proceeding in the investigating in our diary. So it is the mandatory provision to police officer, he write every small or big event or during the investigation in the police or case diary under section 172. So it is 172. So here answer is option C, 172. I express 172, that's why I take here. Question is here, maintenance of case diary by an investigating officer is mandatory under section 172. So answer C is correct here. Now question number 131, section 167 of CRPC authorize the remand. So here very important, most important section, please read this section. Of an accused is police custody, judicial custody, either A or B, neither A nor B. So it is option C, either A or B. In this section, this section is very important, please read this section. According to 160, under section 167, the magistrate provide, magistrate grant a police custody maximum, here maximum 15 days, but they always give 14 days or below that, because they want to save this for any further requirement. So police remand is for only police remand, it is police remand 15 days, and judicial custody for 60 days or 90 days. 90 days in capital punishment and life imprisonment and 10 year offense belong to above 10 year punishment, 10 year punishment, and all remaining offense related to getting the judicial custody for 60 days. So in 90 days custody, in only cases where the cases which are punishable for offense in capital punishment, life imprisonment or imprison for or above 10 year, and remaining is getting 60 days judicial custody. Now question number 132, the section 167 of CRPC applicable during investigation, inquiry, trial, all of the above. So here answer is option A, investigation, because the investigation is not completed. Investigation is completed and report filed under section 173 by the police officer. So before this section 173, all the provision are related to the during investigation, and after this section, and also the investigation conducted by the police officer, if he asked the magistrate to grant extra time and for further inquiry, further investigation here, so it is possible. Now question number 133, is a competent to record the statement or confession under section 164, police officer A police officer confirmed with the power of special executive magistrate. An executive magistrate, neither police officer nor a police officer confirmed the power of special executive magistrate and nor executive magistrate. So here answer is D, because only metropolitan MM plus judicial magistrate can record the examination of accused or witness under section 164. Now question number 134. Under section 164 of CRPC, the statement then confession, other than confession, can be recorded by magistrate where a person who intend to make a such statement appear before a magistrate on his own. Option B, can be recorded by magistrate, and where the person who intend to make such statement is produced or sponsored by the defense. Option C, cannot be recorded by a magistrate unless the person who intend to make a such statement is produced or sponsored by the investigating officer. Option D, can be recorded by a magistrate without going into a question as how or who has produced or sponsored the person and who intend to make a such statement. So in this question, answer is here option C, cannot be recorded by magistrate unless the person who intend to make it such statement is produced or sponsored by the investigating officer. Now question number 135. The obtaining a signature on confession of the person making the confession under section 164 of CRPC is mandatory, discretionary, being procedural, discretionary and optional. So it is answer here mandatory, the signature of the witness or accused, and if they are recorded the confession by the magistrate, it mandatory provision according to section 164 subsection 4 and read with section 281. So it is mandatory provision. Now question number 136. Sorry, it is disturb your 136. The failure to get a signature of the person making the confession is not very material. So here answer, here question is, the failure to get signature of, here failure, signature of a person making the confession is not very material if the making a such statement is not dispatched by the accused. Not very material even if the making of a statement is disputed by the accused. Not very material irrespective of whether making of such statement is disputed or not disputed by the accused, and the defect is curable under section 463 of CRPC. Very material in all circumstances and is fatal. So it is very important here. So answer is here option A, not very material if making a such statement is not dispatched by the accused. If dispatched by the accused, it is material, but if dispatched by, not dispatched by the accused, it is immaterial, not very material. Now question number 137. Under section 164 of CRPC, provided for recording of the confession by accused person and statement by any person. So here confession by accused person, the statement given by the person who is such statement is belonging to the offense, and he accept his offense. So such statement is a confession here. So other than the accused, if any person giving a statement before the court related to the offense, it is a statement. It also called the admission in the context of the evidence. Now option B, confession by accused person and a statement by any person including an accused. Option C, the statement by witness only. Option D, the confession and statement by an accused person. So here I read again here question. Section 164 provided for recording. So recording option B is here. Confession by accused person and statement by any person including accused. So option B. This any word is very important. Any person include witness as well as accused. Now question number 138. Section 164 of CRPC provides a special procedure for recording of confession, the statement made during a course of investigation, confession as well as the statement made during the course of investigation. Option D, either A or B. So it is option C is correct. Confession as well as statement made during the course of investigation, but it is conducted by the MM Metropolitan Magistrate and JM Judicial Magistrate. Now question number 139. A non-confessional statement recorded under section 164 of CRPC, non-confessional. It is a substantive piece of evidence. Is not a substantive piece of evidence, may or may not be substantive evidence depending on the fact and circumstance, all of the above. So it is option B is correct here. Is not a substantive evidence according to section 157 and 147 under Evidence Act, Indian Evidence Act 1872. So, this statement is used under section 157 and contradicting the witness and impeaching the character of the witness. So, these provisions are provided in Indian Evidence Act according to section 157 and 145. Sorry, here 45, not 50, 45 here. Now, final question of this video. A confessional statement recorded in according with the special procedure under section 164 of CRPC can be used as a substantive evidence without being formally proved. So here very important question, and can be proved as substantive evidence without being formally proved. Most important point here. Now option B, cannot be used as a substantive evidence at all. Cannot be used as substantive evidence without being formally proved. Option D is either B or C. So in this question, the recording of the confession under section 164, it is confessional statement here. So the many provision in section 30 of Evidence Act and accomplice statement, in the context of we take the accomplice, so 133 of Evidence Act, so this option is correct here. But if we read the section 114 illustration B of section Indian Evidence Act, so this provision is correct. So according to your choice, but I take here option C, but you may also take option A in answer of this question. So now question number 140, final question, answer is here. Cannot be used the confession statement recorded and according with the special procedure under section 164 of CRPC cannot be used as substantive evidence without being formally proved, means without corroboration it cannot be proved as substantive evidence. But according to section 133, it used as answer here option A, the can be proved as substantive evidence without formally proved. So thank you for watching this video, and if you like this video, please click on like button. There are some mistakes and by speaking, but I am trying to remove it. So please like this video and don't forget to share and subscribe our channel. Thank you.